By far the most important survival item one can possibly have is the will to survive. I've never been fond of locked doors. The legend tells us that the kings of Tibet were descendants from heaven with ropes attaching them to heaven itself. When they died, a heavenly creature would pull the ropes up, bringing their bodies up with them. As Charles Kane notes in his superb history of the Iron Curtain, there were numerous historical precedents against the practicality or feasibility of the fortress system of foreign policy. Something's missing. I wonder where this goes. And even as their hooves shook the earth beneath him, Gilead gathered his remaining strength and drew back his bow. The Trials of Gilead, Volume 1. This book's not very interesting. And there he stood, assuring all within earshot of his coming victory until it was time to return to his ships, leaving Athens to undertake his mighty task.
Ha!
But the new pharaoh was not content with all that was now his. No, Ramses II wanted even more. He had visions of an empire so spectacular, all mankind would come to marvel at its glory. By far the most intriguing is the legend surrounding the fabled dagger of Zion and the awesome power it wields. No wonder Father never got lost. With the Silk Road bringing thousands of travellers into the region annually, Delhi was soon overrun by merchants selling goods of every possible description. It was here in the 6th century BC, between the Aventine and the Palatine Hills, that the Circus Maximus was born. I've read all of these. Now all I need is something to shoot. This could come in handy. This belongs down in the garden. What's it doing in here? The luxury liner, Maria Doria, has never been found. However, treasure hunters the world over search endlessly for its resting place. That's better. The native population of Costa Rica was ravaged by diseases brought by its conquerors and barely managed to survive to see the establishment of a capital city. I've already read this one. Better still, the new 50-caliber round comes with a full metal jacket designed to maximize muzzle velocity and power to the target. While other traps have a similar closing mechanism, it was the Egyptians who perfected the savage effectiveness of the holding barbs. I wonder if Winston read any of it. And Gilead knew the gears of his heart would never turn again as he sacrificed his one true love to save the kingdom he had fought for so long to protect. The Trials of Gilead, Volume 3. It is only through knowing our history that we can learn from the past. Prolific evidence exists that the ancient Eskimos would carve extremely detailed ivory maps of their coastline and hunting waters. Pink is the new black. I think I'll slip into something else. This just proves time never stands still. This should help getting into those hard-to-reach places. This should make for a shorter return trip. No. thought I'd lost this. I wish I hadn't had to do that.
Huh?
I suppose I'll have to order another statue. Splendid. Finally, I'll be able to take that hot shower. Lovely. I do hope Winston will be able to start another fire tonight. Ah, yes. What a delightfully gruesome display. Now I'm getting somewhere. What a lovely tune. When Lord Byron gave the Bridge of Sighs its name in the 19th century, he imagined what it must have been like for a prisoner to take one final look at the beauty of Venice before being led to their fate in the prison below. In the summer, the risk of flooding should not be discounted, as a single rainfall can easily last for days, overflowing the Paria River and threatening Santa Cruz de la Sierra and the Bolivian lowlands to the south.